Convex lens is called converging lens and concave lens is called diverging lens. Why we call it converging? Converging means after it means the ray which is going parallel, it will get converged. It means it will get bent. It will be pressed, bent towards a point. Diverging means the parallel rays will emerge like this, will emerge after refraction. So it is called diverging ray, this is converging ray. When the rays are converging at a point, that is called converging of rays. So for converging lens or convex lens, converging lens or convex lens, let us take the convex lens here. So this is the principal axis for the convex lens, and for this, this is surface number 1, this is surface number 2. For surface number 1, the center of curvature will be here, C1, for the first surface center. For the second surface, the center of curvature will be here, C2. So this is the optic center, we can see. And a ray incident parallel, to the principal axis, it should be paraxial ray. Paraxial ray means it is very parallel to the principal axis but closer to the principal axis, not away from the parallel and away from the principal axis. When it is incident and this, we know at this surface there will occur, at this surface there will occur a refraction, because this is rarer medium, this is rarer medium, and this is a denser medium, again this is rarer medium, air, glass, rare. So at this surface when it is incident, this is the, for this surface we will be drawing normal with respect to this center of curvature. So this is the normal. So from rarer to denser, if it goes, it will try to bend towards the normal. Instead of, it is expected to go like this, but it will turn, bend towards the normal. It means instead of going like this, it will bend towards the normal. That is, this is the normal. So it will bend towards the normal like this. Within the medium, it will go in a straight line. So first it will bend towards the normal like this. Again, at this again, there is an interface. Talk like this. Towards the normal. Again, denser medium, rarer medium, refraction will take place. Here the normal is. For the second surface, we draw the normal from the second center of curvature. This is the normal dash, this is N. So again, from denser to rarer, what will do? The rays, instead of going like this, it will try to bend away from the bend. This is the normal. Now it will try to bend instead of going like this. Like this, this is the normal, this is the ray, and denser to rarer medium, it will bend away from this normal. So it will go like this. It will not go like this, it will go like this. So the image will be formed here, and this is, and same way, if another ray is coming like this parallel to this one, it will also, after refraction through the surface, it will form the image like this. So in general, we can say a convex lens acts as a converging lens. It means the rays are converged and the image is formed. Object is at infinity, image is formed, that is why it is called converging. It bends the ray towards a point, that is why it is called converging lens. Now let's talk about the concave lens. For concave lens, diverging action of concave lens. Let's take the concave lens. This is a concave lens. Thin at the center, and this is the principal axis. A ray coming parallel to the concave lens. This is concave lens. Diverging action of concave lens. Let us take a ray like this. It is coming parallel to this. To take one more ray, this is also coming parallel to this one. So here, this is the first surface. This is the second surface. First surface with respect to the incident ray. This is first surface. So we will have C1 here for the first surface. For the second surface, center of curvature will be here. So a ray is incident at this surface. We draw a normal at this point. When we draw the normal, and from this is rarer, this is denser. So rarer to denser, the ray is supposed, we expect to go straight, but it will bend towards the normal. I mean, instead of going, this is the normal, it will go towards the normal and go in a straight line within the medium. Then again, at this point, it experiences a refraction because of change in medium. So we draw the normal at this point with respect to the center. This is N2, this is N1. When again denser to rarer medium, this is rarer medium, and in the rarer medium what will happen? The ray will try to bend away from the normal. This is the normal, this is also normal, this is also normal, but we have to consider the normal in the second medium where it is refracted. So it means it is expected to go like this, but it will bend, instead of like this from the normal, it will bend away from the normal, it will go like this. So this way also it will go like this. Simply we can write like this for concave lens. For concave lens, when parallel rays are incident on the lens, this ray will go, because it is going optical through the optical center, that's why it will go undeviated. So any ray is parallel to this one, it will, after refraction through the lens, it will go like this. And this one, after refraction, so this is called diverging lens, because the rays are actually diverged, the parallel rays are diverged. Here, in case of convex lens, the parallel rays are converged.